I'm gonna have a hard time trying to figure out how to pronounce that episode. I swear it's like Trail Now or something.
But anywho, this week we have a Futtershy Rainbow Dash centered episode, and I think this episode is pronounced Flutter Brother something? Because it's basically the first time that we have the episode centered around Fluttershy's brother, or at least the first appearance of the brother of Futtershy, because, yeah, you want to know that Futtershy is a brother, right? And this episode's here to prove it. Because after last week, and we have Applejack apparently fixing up the spa, we have Futtershy and Rainbow Dash trying to help out Fluttershy's brother, you know, try to become something. And this episode, I will say, is, it was okay, but let's see if I could find something that's good about it for the most part. So, it's obvious from the beginning that we have the, so it's obvious from the beginning that the characters start off, so it's obvious from the beginning that her brother comes in and wants to stay in at her parents' home because, obviously, he's just a homeless bum who doesn't have a place to live. And with that in mind, he winds up rearranging the place without his parents' permission. Or at least his parents doesn't have, like, some assertiveness. Again, they don't learn from Futtershy, or at least don't step in to say, don't do this or don't do that or anything like that. So that's when basically Futtershy steps in and tells the parents that they can't, that the brother can't do anything and they need to, that he needs to move out of their place, only to have the brother move into Fluttershy's home. Which is bad luck to Futtershy. And by pure coincidence, this is when Futtershy starts to realize that his brother is an instant quitter. Because one moment, or at least he's an easy manipulator. How, where are the signs? Well, one moment he assigns him to a job. Well, actually, I forgot to say the name of him. His name is Zephyr. Futtershy assigns his brother Zephyr to a job at Rarity's Boutique, painting sheets. Her cat, Opalescence, winds up coming across the paint or whatever, which gives him an idea, and next thing you know, they come across it, and her place is a mess. And he's just laying on the bed, just reading or whatever. They obviously go to Twilight's place, where basically Zephyr has to clean all the windows. However, when Spike's there to supervise, he asks about what's the good cleaning techniques, and Spike basically is, he gets manipulated into cleaning the windows. But an instant sign of when he's an instant quitter is when he gets assigned to be in, gets assigned to Rainbow Dash to go up to the Wonder Bolt training, and that's when that's when he gets zapped by, like, all the lightning clouds or whatever, that he just quits instantly. He doesn't want to be a part of it anymore. And that's the signs of an instant quitter right there. So, that's that. When this is found out, that's when Futtershy just instantly kicks him out of the house. And he starts to live in the middle of the woods like, I don't know, like a homeless person. Or should say, like a homeless pony. So, there's that. It's obvious that Futtershy feels so sorry that she kicked her only brother out of the home, as they find, as they obviously go to talk to him about maybe trying to fix that wig that he has via song, which I do have to see, it actually is pretty catchy, but it might take me a little while to get used to that song to maybe actually listen to it. Maybe a few lessons to it at maybe a meetup or so, and I'll maybe get down with it. And from that point, her brother actually tries and tries and tries, and actually succeeds in fixing the wig. But the only reason that he actually does fix the wig is because he feels like he can't succeed because Futtershy and her friends are, you know, are like the bigger succeeders of the family. Like, they managed to defeat villains and all that. And their, like, family can't compete against what they did in Equestria and all that. So, that's the problem that Zephyr faces when he faces trying to do a task or anything. And why he wants to be, like, a lazy bum. But, of course, after he fixes the wig and everything, he obviously becomes a successor and graduates from his, you know, his wig fixing, starts to do everything that everyone tells him to do, and that's how everything goes in the episode. Personally, in my opinion, this is probably the most great episode for anything that speaks out to a person who basically says, oh, I can't succeed, I can't do this, or I can't do that. And definitely, I would say, in the very least, I could basically feel like this is the episode that definitely speaks towards me, because, I mean, definitely, like, this is like a personal story for me. In high school, and this is a true story, back in high school, I made a whole ton of episodes. I made, like, a summary of 26 or so episodes of my reviews, two of which you can see, I believe, right now on Daily Motion. Some may wonder, why not Zipcast? Unfortunately, Zipcast is getting shut down, which, rest in peace, Zipcast. So I'm gonna need to find a new home for the reviews now. And I'm trying to figure out where could I put the new episodes up. I obviously can't put the new episodes up on Daily Motion because I'll need to fight the copyrights or whatever. And these companies are given too much power. And I can't do it without, like, trying to edit these episodes down. And, you know, my problem with the Equestria Girls episode, and I have to put the episode up on Daily Motion just to avoid that claim. So, with everything that went on with this episode, definitely I could feel a lot about it. And I'm just trying to figure out where my place is. Do I want to be a movie person? Do I want to be a reviewer? Do I want to be an actor? I mean, there were so many paths that I was confused on throughout this whole episode. I mean, I'm still trying to figure out where do I put my Furb Guy episodes on. And where do I go? Do I go to a college? Do I go to a community college? I mean, my high school pretty much robbed me of my... My high school pretty much robbed me of some way of getting me to a... of getting me to a college that will get me my acting degree. But now that I figured out that there was a community college that actually does acting, I might, just might, be able to get some way of be able to get an acting degree that I might be able to get some way of be able to get one step closer to going to Hollywood. I just haven't filled out my application yet just to see whether or not I can get to the community college yet. It's because my parents are so lazy in filling out the forms. But off topic here. But I'm trying to see whether or not acting or movie reviews, or just trying to see whether or not, like you know, I'm like a multi-talented person here. Like, I like to do just about everything, try to see whether or not my talent's in here or there or just about everywhere. Like, I want to do, like, I want to try just about everything. And, like, you saw my con vlogs, and I'm just trying to, and I want to do just about everything. I want to, it's like that Shakira song from Zootopia. I want to try everything. And I just want to find my place in the world before the day is done. So it's just, I want to find my true calling card. Is it through movie reviews? Is it through journalistic forms? Is it through PMVs? Is it through gaming? Is it through is it for what? Exactly. But I need to try stuff. I need to try new things. And that's what this episode, maybe what I understand, is calling out for. Exactly. At least that's what I get out of it. So, I just want to ask you guys, what do you think about the episode? So, just leave your comments down below on what you think about the episode. Personally, in my regards, it's pretty much fun. In my regards, it's good. And I just got to give a nod to the Easter egg that I saw a Zelda pony in there. Or should say, Link pony. Because technically it's not Zelda, because it's not an address or whatever. But it's a Link pony, and he's walking around in a cart with a bunch of rubies. It's just a funny gag. But next week, I'm going in with the episode blind because I forgot to take a look at the guide. So I'll see you guys for next week's episode. And not a TV guide for messing up next week, and for messing up this week's for this week's episode, because they listed it under My Little Pony instead of My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. So, nod to you, TV Guide and Dish, for messing up that episode. So, anyways, see you guys for next week's episode.